Namaste, good morning to you all and also welcome to today's mathematics class. In the previous class, we have discussed chapter 3, that is square and square roots. Hope you have revised well. In today's session, we shall discuss the fourth chapter, that is cubes and cube roots. Let's move on to the topic. Consider the natural numbers 1 to 10. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Let's multiply the numbers three times by itself. That means one into one. Two into two. Three into three. 4 into 4 into 4. 5 into 5 into 5. 6 into 6 into 6. 7 into 7 into 7. 8 into 8 into 8. 9 into 9 into 9. 10 into 10 into 10. 1 into 1 into 1. 1 into 1 into 1. 1. 2 into 2 into 2. 2 multiplied by 3 times. 8. 3 into 3 is 9. 9 into 3 is 27. 4 into 4 into 4. 4 into 4 is 16. 16 into 4 64. 5 into 5 into 5. 5 into 5. 5 5s are 25. 25 into 5 125. 6 into 6 into 6. 6 are 36. 36 into 6. 216. Then 7 into 7 into 7. 7 into 7. 49. 49 into 7. 300. 43. 8 into 8 into 8. 8 8s are 64. 64 into 8. 512. Then 9 into 9 into 9. 9 9s are 81. 81 into 9. 729. 10 into 10 into 10. 10 tens are 100. 100 into 10. 1000. So 1 8 27. 64. 125. 216. 343, etc. 2000. These numbers are cube numbers. Today we shall discuss more about cube numbers. When a number is multiplied 3 times by itself, the product obtained is called cube of a number. For a given number m, the cube of m is m into m. M multiplied by 3 times, denoted by m cube. Read as m cube. 1 8 27, etc. That means 1 into 1 into 1, 1. 2 into 2 into 2, 8. 3 into 3 into 3, 27. 4 into 4 into 4, 64, etc. These numbers are called perfect cubes. Next, we shall discuss properties of cube numbers. The first property, the cube of an odd number is O. Consider an odd number 3. The cube of an odd number means 3 cube is equal to 3 into 3 into 3. 3 3s are 9. 9 into 3 27. So 3 is an odd number. The cube of 3 is 27. 27 is also an odd number. The next property, the cube of an even number is even. Consider an even number 4. 4 cube is equal to 4 multiplied by 3 times. 4 into 4 into 4. 4 4s are 16. 16 into 4 64. Here 4 is an even number. The cube of 4 is 64. 64 is also an even number. The next property, the cube of a positive number is positive. Consider a positive number 2. Positive number 2. So 2 cube is equal to 2 into 2 into 2. So 2 into 2 is 4. 4 into 2 is 8. Is equal to 8. Here are positive numbers. So the answer is plus 8. So here 2 is a positive number. The cube of 2 is 8. 8 is also a positive number. The last property, fourth property, the cube of a negative number is negative. Consider a negative number minus 5. So minus 5 the whole cube is equal to minus 5 into minus 5 into minus 5 is equal to, multiplication of two negative numbers is always positive. Again, positive into negative, negative. 5 into 5, 25. 25 into 5, 125. Minus 5 is a negative number. The cube of minus 5 is minus 125. So the answer minus 125 is also a negative number. So the cube of a negative number is negative. Next property, the cube of a number can be written as the sum of consecutive odd numbers. For example, consider the cube of 3. 3. So 3 cube is equal to, no, what is the value of 3 cube? 3 multiplied by 3 times. So 3 into 3 into 3. 3 into 3 into 3 is 27. So 27 can be written as the sum of 3 consecutive odd numbers is equal to dash plus dash plus dash. And write 3 consecutive odd numbers. So we have to find out the first addend. So to find the first addend, we use the formula n into n minus 1 plus 1. N into n minus 1 plus 1. Here the number is 3. So substitute n is equal to 3. So 3 into 3 minus 1 plus 1. 3 into 3 minus 1, 2. 3 into 2 plus 1. So 6 plus 1, 7 is the first addend. So 7. You have to find the first addend, 7. What's the next odd number? Next odd number, adding 2. So 9. The next odd number, 11. So add 7 plus 9, 16. 16 plus 11, 27. So, the cube of a number can be written as the sum of the consecutive odd numbers. One more example. Consider the cube of 5. 5 cube is equal to 5 multiplied by 3 times. 5 into 5 into 5, 125. So 125 can be written as the sum of the consecutive 5 odd numbers. Dash plus, dash plus, dash plus, dash plus, dash. So first we have to find out the first addend. So use the formula n into n minus 1 plus 1. So substituting n is equal to 5. 5 into 5 minus 1 plus 1 is equal to 5 into 5 minus 1, 4 plus 1. So 20 plus 1, 21. So the first addend is 21. What is the next odd number? 21, then 23, then 25, 27, then 29. Adding 21 plus 23, 44. 44 plus 25, then 27, 29, we get 125. So cube of a number can be written as the sum of the consecutive odd numbers. Next, we shall discuss the exercise questions. First problem from exercise 4.1. Evaluate the following. First option A cube. A cube means 8 multiplied by 3 times. 8 into 8. 8 8s are 64. 64 into 8, 512. Then the next option, minus 6 the whole cube. It's an empty number, okay? Minus 6 the whole cube. C equal to minus 6 into minus 6 into minus 6. We already studied the cube of a negative number is always negative. C equal to minus 6 into 6, 36. 36 into 6, 216. So minus 216. The third option, 11 cube. 11 cube, Z equal to the positive number. So 11 into 11. 11 11s are 121. 121 into 11. 1, 2, 1. Again, 1, 2, 1. Adding 1, 2 plus 1, 3. 2 plus 1, 3, 1. So 1,331. The next question, find the digit in the ones place for the cubes of the following numbers. The first one, 17. The digit in the ones place is 7. So 7 cube. 7 cube is 7 into 7 into 7. 7 sevens are 49. 49 into 7, 343. So the digit in the ones place of 343 is 3. The answer is 3. The digit in the ones place for the cube of 17 is 3. So here the unit place is 7. First we have to find out the cube of 7. 7 cube is equal to 7 into 7 into 7. 7 sevens are 49. 49 into 7 is 343. So the unit place in the digit is 3. So the digit in the ones place for the cube of 17 is 3. Next option, 30. Here the digit in the ones place of 30 is 0. So the digit in the ones place for the cube of 30 is also 0. The digit in the ones place for the cube of 30. 30 is 0. The next option, 152. The digit in the ones place is 2. First we have to find out the cube of 2. 2 cube is equal to 2 into 2 into 2. 2 2 is 4. 4 into 2, 8. So the digit in the ones place for the cube of 152 is 8. So the digit in the ones place for the cube of 152 is 8. Next question, question number 3. Which of the following numbers is a perfect cube? Show your reason. The first option, 1728. First we have to find out the prime factors of 1728. So start with 2. 8 2s are 16. Then balance 1, 12. 6 2s are 12. 2 4s are 8. Then again 2. 4 2s are 8. 3 2s are 6 and 2 2s are 4. Again 2. 2 2s are 4. 1 2s are 2. Then on balance 12. 6 2s are 12. Then again 2. 1 2s are 2. Then 1. Here 0. 16. 8 2s are 16. Again 2. 5 2s are 10. 4 2s are 8. Again 2. 2 2s are 4. 7 2s are 14. Yeah, this is an odd number, so start with 3. 9 3s are 27. Again 3. 3 3s are 9. Again 3. 1. So 1728. 1728 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2. Again 2 into 2 into 2. Into 3 into 3 into 3. Here the factor 2 appears 3 times. Again the factor 2 appears thrice. Again the factor 3 appears 3 times. 2 into 2 into 2, 2 cube into again 2 into 2 into 2, 2 cube into 3 into 3 into 3, 3 cube. Here each factor appears 3 times. Each factor appears thrice. So it is a perfect cube. The question is which of the following numbers is a perfect cube? So 1728 is a perfect cube because the factors come in groups of 3. Because the factors come in groups of 3. Next option, option B, 3025. First we have to find out the prime factors of 3025. Here the unit digit is 5, so it starts with 5. How many 5s are in 30? 6 5s are 30. Then 2 is not possible. Here 0, then take 25. 5 5s are 25. Again 5. 1 5s are 5. Then balance 1 10. 2 5s are 10. Then 1 5s are 5. So the unit digit is 1. So we start with the odd number. So 3 is not possible. 5. Then you take 9, 7 or 9. Then 11. 11 11s are 121. Again 11. 1. So 3025 can be written as 5 into 5 into 11 into 11. Here 2 5s are there and 2 11s are there. 5 appears 2 times and 11 appears twice. So it is not a perfect cube. 3025 is not a perfect cube because the factors do not come in group of 3 because the factors do not come in group of 3. Each factor appears twice. So it is not a perfect cube. The next option, 3375. First we have to find out the prime factors of 3375. Unit digit is 5, so we start with 5. 6 5s are 30, then balance 3, 37. 7 5s are 35, again balance 2, 25. 5 5s are 25. Then again 5. 1 5s are 5, then 17. 3 5s are 15, then balance 2, 25. 5 5s are 25. Again 5. 2 5s are 10, then balance 3, 35. 7 5s are 35. The unit digit is 7, so we start with 3, 9 3s are 27. Again 3, 3 3s are 9. Again 3, 1. So it can be written as 3375 can be written as 5 into 5 into 5 into 3 into 3 into 3 is equal to 5 into 5 into 5. Here the factor 5 appears 3 times and the factor 3 appears twice. 5 cube into 3 into 3 into 3, 3 cube. Each factor appears twice. So 3375 is a perfect cube. So 3375 is a perfect cube because the factors come in groups of 3. Next question. Find the smallest number that can be multiplied with 3025 to make the product a perfect cube. First we have to find out the prime factors of 3025. Every digit is 5, we start with 5. 6 5s are 30, again 2, put 0, 25. 5 5s are 25. Again 5, 1 5 is 5, then balance 1, 0. 2 5s are 10, 1 5s are 5. Then 11, 11 11s are 21, and 11, 1. So 3025 can be written as 5 into 5 into 11 into 11. Here the factor 5 appears twice and the 11 appears twice. So it is not a perfect cube. We need one more 5 and 11 to get groups of 3. So it is not a perfect cube. So we need one more 5 and 11 to get groups of 3. So the smallest number, to be multiplied is at 5 into 11. 5 into 11 is equal to 55. 5 into 11 is equal to 55. Here 5 appears 2 times and 11 appears 2 times. We need one more 5 and 11 to get the groups of 3. So the smallest number to be multiplied is 5 into 11. 5 into 11 is 55. Next question. Question number 5. Express the following as a sum of odd numbers. The first option 9, 2. So we have to express 9, 2 as a sum of 9 consecutive odd numbers. For that we have to find out the first addend. First addend n into n minus 1 plus 1. Here n is equal to 9. Substitute n is equal to 9. 9 into 9 minus 1 plus 1. Is equal to 9 into 9 minus 1. 8. 9 into 8 plus 1. 72 plus 1. 73. So the first addend is 73. So 9 2 can be written as sum of 9 consecutive odd numbers. So 9 2 is equal to the first addend is 73. 73 plus next odd number 75 plus 77 plus 79, 81, then 83, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 85, 87 and 89. Have to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it can be expressed as the sum of 9 consecutive odd numbers. Next option, 11 cube. So we have to express 11 cube as a sum of 11 consecutive odd numbers. First we have to find out the first addend. The formula is n into n minus 1 plus 1. So 11 into, here n is equal to 11. 11 into 11 minus 1 plus 1. So 11 into 11 minus 1, 10. 11 into 10 plus 1. 110 plus 1 is equal to 111. So 11 cube can be written as, the first addend is 111 plus, what is the next odd number? 113, then 115, then 70, what is the next odd number? 90, then 121 plus 123 plus 125 plus 127 plus 129 plus 131. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So it can be expressed the 11 consecutive, sum of the 11 consecutive odd numbers. Next question, question number 6. Give two numbers for A such that A square is equal to A cube. We have to find two numbers whose squares and cubes are equal. It is possible only with 0 and 1. 0 square is equal to 0 and 1 square is equal to 1. 0 cube is equal to 0 and 1 cube is equal to 1. So the required numbers are 0 and 1. Therefore, the required numbers are 0 and 1. Next question, find the following cubes without actual multiplication. The first option, A cube. We know that A cube can be expressed as the sum of the first consecutive 8 odd numbers. So we have to find out the first addend. The formula is n into n minus 1 plus 1. Here n is 8. So 8 into 8 minus 1 plus 1 is equal to 8 into 7 plus 1 is equal to 56 plus 1 is equal to 57. The first addend is 57. So A cube can be written as, the first addend is 57. Then write the next odd number, 59. Then 61, 63, then 65, 67, then 69 plus 71. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How to express the 8 consecutive odd numbers? Then adding 57, 59, 61, 63, 65, 67, 69, 71. 9 plus 7, 16, then 17, 17 plus 3, 20, 25, 32, 32 plus 9, 41, 41 plus 1, 42, balance 4, 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 5, 14, 14 plus 6, 20, 26, 32, 32 plus 6, 38 plus 6, 44, 44 plus 7, 51 is equal to 512. 8 cube is equal to 512. The next option, 10 cube. We know from the properties of cube numbers, a perfect cube can be written as the sum of the parts equal to odd numbers. So 10 cube can be written as the sum of the parts equal to 10 odd numbers. We have to find out the first addend. The first addend is equal to, the formula is n into n minus 1 plus 1. Here n is equal to 10. So 10 into 10 minus 1 plus 1. 10 into 9 plus 1. 90 plus 1. 91 is the first addend. So 10 cube is equal to, the first addend is 91 plus, what's the next odd number? 93 plus 95 plus 97 plus 99 plus 101 plus 103 plus 105 plus 107 plus 109. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Adding these numbers, 91, 93, 95, 97, 99, then 101, 103, 105, 107, and 109. Adding 1 plus 3, 4, 4 plus 5, 9, 9 plus 7, 16, 16 plus 9, 25, 26, 29, 34, 34 plus 7, 41, 41 plus 9, 50, balance 5, 9 plus 5, 14, 14 plus 9, 14 plus 9, 23, then 23 plus 9, 32, 41, 50, again 0, balance 5, 5 plus 1, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, is equal to 1000. 10 cube, 10 cube is equal to 1000.
Today we have discussed cube numbers and its properties. Hope it is clear for you all. If you have any doubt, please note it and keep. We will discuss it during the online session. Thank you for watching. Namaste.